Mercenary Field in Chirac, Illinois is the setting for today's MFL action. The historic site is where aliens first made contact with Earth, landing their spaceships inside the stadium and demanding a lifetime supply of Italian beef sandwiches. And today's matchup is going to be a good one. The teams are taking the field. The Grim Bay Attackers battle the Midway Mutants. Welcome to MFL Game Day. Grim Blitzrow here. Let's listen in on the sidelines and hear what the team's captains have to say. Welcome to MFL Sunday School, where the good playbook teaches it's an eye for no reason, a tooth for an eight ball, and a limb for just looking at me the wrong way. MFL Game Day is on the air. Grim Blitzrow, my partner's Bricks and Bricks Jr. Hey, man, these guys flat out want to kill each other today.
Yeah, these are the kind of games families come out to see. It's good for the sport.
You know what I like about this home team is 90% of them were born criminally insane. You can't teach that. Looks like the defense called the ginormous dirty trick. That's a whole lot of player right there.
Ooh, hope he's got a good chiropractor.
And it's first and 10. He's not just burning down the house, he's taking it to the house. Oh, that was a big hit. Hey, Bricks, I bet you took a lot of shots like that over your career.
Let's see. About a quarter after three, Grim, but my watch is a bit slow.
Second down in a very lot. Oh, what a great defensive play that was, Bricks. Kind of like your Aunt Bertha. This guy has some big balls. What a hit.
Yeah, she does have a big pair, Grim. You're right.
He picks up a two. Second and 8 to go. QB passes it for maybe a yard. They've got to open up the offense here, Bricks. And that'll bring up third down and 7. And the quarterback finds his man for the first down. First down and 6. Oh, and did he just put on a display there? Touchdown! Don't try to get fancy here. Just put the ball down and kick it.
In that order, Grim?
It's good. The home crowd isn't impressed with that showing, but their team has a chance to respond. First and 10. Oh, that's a vicious hit, and the crowd loves it.
He just turned that guy into 300 pounds of ground mutant meat.
And you can't hit a guy much harder than that. And that is unfortunate. A Good run for 5 yards.
Hey, didn't move the change of score, did it? How good can it be?
Third and two. And he's running like a moose. Defense was there, but he still picked up a yard somehow. And the punter takes a break from knitting on the sidelines to come in and punt.
His knitting is superb, Grim. The cross-stitching, unbelievable.
The return man catches the ball and heads upfield. Ooh, that hit's gonna shave a few days off his life. And it's first and ten. Second down and more than the QB would like. Heard footsteps and took his eye off the ball.
What a peck ahead. Catch the ball, asshole. Hey, asshole, up here. Talking to you.
And this guy runs angry and runs hard. First down. And it's first and ten. First down and don't die. See, it's really a simple game when it comes down to it. And it's first and ten. And he runs it for 4 yards. Second down and six. If you don't hear it coming, it'll knock you right on your ass. And he's off to the races. Look at that little mutant run.
I don't think you can see that, Grim.
Well, this should be an easy chip shot extra point, but you never know with kickers. The kick is good.
As expected, those are pretty much just gimmies.
When you give up points, you need to get them back. Here comes the kickoff. Let's see if they can make him pay. First and ten. Nice run for 5 yards. Second down and five. And he picks up maybe 4 on that play. Quarter one comes to an end. If they don't get it together, this game is going to turn into a rout. And that'll bring up third and one. Man, guys like a freight train. Nice pickup there for a first down. And it's first and ten. And he runs it for 4 yards. Second down and six. It's about a 3-yard pickup. third down and three. Oh, what a punishing hit that was. And that's how you make a guy remember your name and your shoe size. Because he just walked all over him. And it's first and ten. When it feels like to have your teeth removed without Novocaine.
If I had all my teeth knocked out like that, I'd have them made into dice, Grim. It'd be fun to gamble with my own teeth.
I'm not sure who he was throwing to on that play. Third down and five. Nothing was going to stop him from getting into the end zone.
Except maybe self-doubt, but he seems to have worked through it.
Well, little chip shot here, extra point, but this guy could blow it. Straight through the uprights. Here comes the kickoff. Let's see if the defense can hold them. They're going to be able to return this one. And it's first and ten. Running like he had a load in his pants. Picks up maybe two.
We always ran with a load in our pants, Grim. It's a pretty good defensive tool. Except the zombies. They are freaks.
First down. Give this guy a few catches and watch his confidence take off. He is deadly in the open field, Bricks. First and ten. Nicely done for a first down. And it's first and ten. Sticks his fingers in the defender's eyes, netting him a pickup of about eight on the play. Second down and two. Oh, great catch! And that's a touchdown! Touchdown! Don't want to make any mistakes here. Just kick the ball through the upright, for God's sake. It goes right through.
Yeah, like a double stuffed burrito from Taco Hell.
They need a good return here to set up the offense. Not a bad kick, but not a great one either.
Well, his nickname is Lukewarm.
And he's proud of that?
Yeah, that's why he named his clothing company Lukewarm Threads. Their marketing team hates it.
And it's first and ten.
Much like my wedding night, there was a big explosion, but then everyone left disappointed.
Everyone? You had more than two people in the room?
Yeah, the guy filming the clown. Somebody's got to make the balloon animals.
Oh, my gosh! The defensive player looks like he's lost his mind!
Now, that's just the berserker rage kicking in. He's leaving a wake of destruction in his path, and the body toll continues to climb. with the brain scrambler. And it's first and ten. For a 9-yard gain. And the 2-minute warning sounds. Time to get a beer.
Hey, get me one too.
And that'll bring up 2nd and 1. Timeout.
How predictable. Surprise us next time. Call the timeout during halftime.
3rd down and the punter is warming up. That's a killer. It was right there and then he dropped it.
Oh, scumbag is killing me in the fantasy league.
You know, sometimes the best thing to do is just punt and let your defense get the ball back. Rainbow. Nice catch, and he turns on the afterburners. Punt returners in this league have a life, and he just slipped away like a greased pig. Oh, and that one's gonna hurt. He may not be able to comprehend math after that hit.
What's math?
Exactly. And it's 1st and 10. And the quarterback throws a murder ball, which will slice its way through any defensive player trying to block it. He was not going to drop that one. They need to make him a target more often. The offense calls a timeout. This is why you save your timeouts. You can use them in the 2-minute warning.
Now I get it. Makes sense, Grin.
And it's 1st and 10. And the offense quickly calls their 2nd timeout. That's how you do it. 2nd down and long. Pow! With the brain scrambler!
Hey, timeouts are kind of like condoms, you know, Grim? You gotta use them smart if you want to score. Let's see if they did.
And the quarterback goes into a hurry-up offense and calls all the plays from the line of scrimmage from here on out. If there were any functioning brain cells before that hit, they're gone now. He's going to have the IQ of a rutabaga after that hit. Perfect pass and a score!
Yo, seriously, man, you think you can go toe-to-toe with me? I will wreck your world. You understand me, Junior? I'll wreck your world.
Never happened because the defense called a time warp dirty trick and transport their offense back in time.
It's just a jump to the left
and a step to the right.
And he just nailed him right on the numbers for a touchdown.
Yo, man, nobody can touch what I'm on. I take all you mutants out. That's right.
Now, there are some who would argue that we should just skip this step and make touchdowns worth 7.
What, and kick the kicker's job in half? They'd just be called sitters then.
The kick is good!
As expected, those are pretty much just gimmies.
The home team is feeling confident as they get the kickoff into the air.
Scoring makes anyone confident.
It certainly does, Bricks. It certainly does. High five! It's first and 10. Oh, with the brutal hit. Huh. I didn't know that was a penalty.
Yeah, these rule changes are ruining the game, Grim.
First down and long, and they've had enough. The offense jumps on sides and attacks the ref. First down and forever. The ball into the defense, picking up 7. The second quarter comes to a close as the teams head for the locker room, and we take you to halftime. Brought to you by Monsanto Industries. We make genetically engineered food that is to die for. It's the start of the third quarter, and we are set to go, Bricks.
Oh, boy! Where are we going, Grim? A carnival? Huh? Show, where we going?
Hey, why don't you settle down? Just pet your rabbit, Lenny. Just pet your rabbit. They're looking for a good return after giving up points. Let's see how they do.
Yeah, let's see if they always suck or if that was just a one-time thing.
Defensive players
you can't keep a good mutant down.
And they run it for a couple of yards. And that'll be 2nd and 8 to go. This guy's gonna get mugged in the locker room by his team after the game. Third down and 8. And then Cats will give them a first down.
I don't know if they're his, but he sure has a good set of hands.
And it's 1st and 10. Oh, great tackle. When his brain is unscrambled, he'll be thinking about that hit. And that'll be 2nd down and 4. Oh, a great catch, and he picks up a new set of downs. How have they not killed him yet? He's wearing a new mink coat, for God's sake.
He's 7 layers of smarmy, Grim.
Second down and a lot. Offense says it's time to put the ref out of his misery. They just went zebra hunting, and it looks like they got their trophy. Second down and a mile. Third down, and the QB is saying his prayers. And there's a huge gain, and this offense is rolling.
Margaret, that was a pass play. Rolling plays are in bowling.
And they'll line up for the punt here. Oh, no good. A Now that punter's gonna find a cut-off bison head in his bed tonight. And he just lets that one go. He says, no thank you, and the defense downs it. And it's first and 10. First and 10. Oh, devastating hit. You ever get hit that hard, Bricks?
Yep. Third grade. Sister Mary Margaret of Our Ladies of Holy Hell. I thought it was brass knuckles, but it was just a regular knuckles.
Oh, mama. He just knocked him into the next time zone.
Once he finds his head, he'll be okay.
And it's first and 10. And picks up maybe a deuce at most.
Speaking of deuces, I gotta, hey, you got a dollar for the bathroom attendant? He threatened me if I didn't tip him next time.
Return it for a touchdown and change the entire game, but I don't want to nitpick. Third down and 8. Ooh, that hit's gonna shave a few days off his life. Well, sometimes the best thing to do is just punt and let your defense get the ball back. Nice punt. Should move him back nicely. And he's got a chance for a good return here.
One time when I was playing, a guy hit me so hard, I went into a dark tunnel. Thought I saw my grandparents waving at me in the light. Turns out it was just the visitor's tunnel that he knocked me into, and it was the paramedics waving fingers in my face.
And he breaks away. Oh, he almost broke that one wide open.
Hey, speaking of breaking one wide open, who's sitting on the oil rig about to blow? Hey, smells like an oven-baked porta-john in here. We're a freaking fracking accident waiting to happen. Don't nobody light a match.
First down, and the running game opens up for them and allows the passing game to be more of a threat. Gotta keep them guessing. And it's first and 10. Second down in a very lot. And the defense was ready for that bombs away dirty trick that time. Third down and long.
In the past, but I heard the quarterback threaten to throw him a real bomb if he dropped one again. You know, good communication is important.
Oh, the defender lays down a wicked hit and knocks the ball loose. The receiver just got smashed.
Not as bad as me last night. He may be dead, but trust me.
Quarter three comes to an end, but this game is far from over and will be decided in the final quarter. Second down and 10. Oh, with a punishing hit. Third down. 7-10. And he zings it in there for a 9-yard completion. They are moving the ball now with authority. It's not short, but this one shouldn't give the kicker any trouble.
Unless he collapses under pressure and never makes another kick again.
That's bleak, Bricks. Straight through the uprights. The teams are lined up for the kickoff. Just catch it, run it back, and don't die. And it's first and 10. Second down and more than the QB would like. And they call it ginormous dirty. There's no reason to drop the ball if you're still alive. It's better to be lucky than good.
You ever get hit in the head with a boat all grim?
Nope.
Well, I have on several occasions.
Not surprising.
Multiple times on each occasion.
Not surprising.
And trust me, that hit was worse.
Oh, and that one's gonna hurt. He may not be able to comprehend math after that hit.
What's math?
Exactly. And it's first and 10. He was starting to go somewhere, but he gets stumped after 3.
They usually stop me after 3, too. You know, the all-you-can-eat buffets? They're not as literal as you'd think.
Second down and 7. First down. You know, Bricks, a lot of people have gotten pass happy in this league. Nice to see some old school mano a mano on the turf, huh? And it's first and 10. Oh, big catch, big run, big touchdown.
And big deal. Mr. Beat for Brain having a ball didn't fall out.
Don't try to get fancy here. Just put the ball down and kick it.
In that order, Grim?
Straight through the uprights. The home crowd isn't impressed with that showing, but their team has a chance to respond. A big hit. Hey, Bricks, I bet you took a lot of shots like that over your career.
Let's see. About a quarter after 3, Grim, but my watch is a bit slow.
And that pass play is good for 8 yards. Second down and 2.
If that hit didn't cripple him, it certainly left skid marks.
And it's first and 10. Great play by the defense. It's not too often a quarterback gets rejected.
That's why that's the position I originally tried out for. I want to know what it's like for other people to accept you.
Now that went from a joke to making me feel feelings. Stop it. This isn't a place to feel feelings. This is talking about Butterfingers. He should have had that one. Third down and 10. Oh, and that's how you play defense. Well, of course, he could have had an interception, returned it for a touchdown, and changed the entire game, but I don't want to nitpick.
I do. The guy should have fucking caught it.
Don't do anything stupid here. Just punt the damn ball and play defense. He boomed that one. Let's see if they can get a return. No return on this punt. The defense will just down it.
I can't tell if he's smart or scared. Either way, the ball is down.
And it's first and 10. And he picks up about 6 on the play. Second down and 4. And that's a nice run for a first down. And it's first and 10. Kaboom! And the quarterback unleashes a sonic blast against the... Nicely done for a first down. The defense calls timeout. They must be trying to get on their QB's good side. And it's first and 10. Calls a second timeout. They really need to make a stop here. Second down and long. Six-yard gain there. That's a solid pickup.
I wish people would do solid pickups more often. I step in dog turd.
The defense calls their last timeout.
I don't know if they can pull off a win, Glenn.
Why is that, Bricks?
Just a gut feeling. It also might be that porterhouse I ate for breakfast.
How are you still alive?
Drugs.
And that was a bone crusher right there, folks. And he's going to have to boot this one halfway to hell. Kick.
Boring. Just give them the ball. Oh, that is such bullshit. I got money on this game. These guys need to talk to the ref about those calls. And by talk, I mean stop them into the ground.
Man, these guys have... And the offense jumps on sides to kill the ref. They say, we're mad as hell and not going to take it anymore. Well, here comes the punting unit. You know, punters really do know how to party, Bricks.
Yeah?
Oh, yeah, I have pictures that, well, maybe actually shouldn't discuss this. And he snags the punt and looks for a man. What a hit that was. The quarterback shifts gears and goes into his hurry-up offense. The quarterback goes down. Zoom on his face. I want to see if he's crying. Second down and a lot. And he reels that one in for a first down to keep the drive alive. And it's first and 10. For a first down. First down and 3. The Mutants walk away defeated. They battled hard but still got their butts handed to them.
Gross. I hope there weren't any orc butts involved.
I kind of like orc butts, especially with some Dijon mustard and a smoked pickle relish. And a bad's living.
Let's go down to the field and see what the game's MVP thinks of today's outcome. We'll be right back. once again, the folks at EvilSN thank our viewing audience and the Mutant Football League for allowing us to telecast this sports presentation. This is Grim Blitzrow with Brickhead Mulligan and Bricks Jr. signing off.
Today's game was brought to you by ComCrack Entertainment. They're not happy until you're not happy.